1984 by George Orwell. Dramatized by Jonathan Holloway, with Christopher Eccleston as Winston Smith.
Winston! Winston, wake up!
Mother?
Mother?
You took the bread?
Yes.
Yes.
Because you were hungry?
Yes.
Yes.
You shouldn't have.
I know.
You can't help it, I forgive you. I don't mind for myself.
Is my sister going to die?
We're all going to die.
Please don't. Don't die, Mother.
You are forgiven. I don't want the last thing you heard from me to be a recrimination. Go outside.
Mother?
Go and find something interesting.
But Mother!
You've got to go now. I won't be here when you come back. Winston, in fact, you mustn't come back.
Mother!
Kindness, Winston. Remember to be kind. Go now. You must go now. Out through the shell hole. Lovely boy! Walk in a straight line! Keep walking!
Kindness, Winston. Remember to be kind.
Mother!
These bleak scenes cannot help but make the gorge rise in our throats. Our pioneer settlers hatched down. The enemy would not even waste a bullet. Small children, this little girl, hacked apart while she screamed for mercy. We, the living, stand in testimony to their bravery, their humanity, and must every day remind ourselves it's a citizen's duty to resist the enemy, support our troops, and revenge the deaths of our fellows.
Fellow citizens of Victory Mansions, and so we begin another day determined to do our bit. And that means being healthy and alert, strong for our nation and for Big Brother, alert to the enemies without and within. We'll start with stretches. Feet flat on the floor and reaching up. That's it. Barker, in flat 36, you can do better than that. Imagine there's a bar running across above you, 6 inches from your fingertips. Stretch, man! Stretch! What's the matter with you, Smith?
What?
6079, Smith, W, stand up straight. Hands above your head. Stretch! Oh. That's it, Smith. You have to show some gumption, Smith.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Sorries! Don't come into it, Smith.
I'm not well. I've not been well for some time.
Nonsense. What you might have been doesn't matter. It's the future that counts. Look to the future. Who controls the past, Smith?
The party controls the past.
Who controls the future?
Who controls the past controls the future.
And what about the present?
Who controls the present controls the past.
And now let's see which of us can touch our toes. Stretch up and then right over forwards from the hips. Stretch up on one, over and down on two. Ready? One and two and one. One and two and one and two.
I have a very bad back.
I'm 39 and I've had 4 children. You can see my knees aren't bent when I go forward. Smith, straighten those knees.
My back.
You can do it. It's a matter of wanting to, of getting it right. And one and two. Anyone under 45 is perfectly capable of touching his toes.
Ah,
Smith! We don't all have the privilege of fighting in the front line, and so we ought to jolly well keep fit. Remember our boys on the Malabar front, and remember the sailors in the floating fortresses. Just think what they have to put up with.
Of course you're right. I'm very sorry.
You are the outer party and the foot soldiers of English socialism. Your privileges bring responsibilities, and one, and two, and you are neither mindless proles nor heroes of the inner party. But Ingsoc relies on the outer party, and you cannot and may not shirk. That's it. That's better, comrades. That's better, Smith.
Thank you.
Even to consider shirking is getting close to thought crime. One, and two, and one, and two. Rest. That's good. And I have some more news. The new radio cameras have been fitted in the corridors. Victory Mansions is privileged to be the first residential block in this sector to have them. They will replace the corridor telescreens that couldn't see around corners. These will make us safe. Powered by electrical motors, they can turn and follow a suspect. Thank you for this gift, big brother. Thank you for keeping us safe. Remember, always do the best you can. For Oceania! For Big Brother!
Just the man I was looking for.
Ah, Syme. How are you?
Working flat out. We need to get the 10th edition of the Newspeak Dictionary out as soon as damn it.
We're still using the 9.
Well, you would be, wouldn't you?
Of course.
Woolly-mindedness? That's not what I put you down for. Now, me, on the other hand, there's still too much of the poet in me. But of course it's out with the old, in with the new. It's thrilling. Chasing down old, unnecessary words and chucking them down the memory hole, so to speak. Oh, watch what you're doing. The cue's moving.
What was it you wanted?
We're getting the language into its final shape. We're destroying words. Scores of them. Hundreds of them every day. We're cutting the language to the bone.
But
big victory this morning. Been staring at me in the face, but for some reason I hadn't clocked it. What's the opposite to bad?
Good, I suppose.
But of course, that doesn't make sense, does it? That the so-called opposite should bear no relationship to the thing it's up against. So, we came up with ungood. Just like that. And then we couldn't stop. For excellent, read plus good. For splendid, double plus good. And so on.
Sounds exciting.
Look over there. I mean, glance, don't stare.
Ah, O'Brien.
Nice to see those inner party fellows coming along and eating with the rest of us. He takes a particular interest in the Newspeak Dictionary, you know. He's a great support to us.
He looks like an intelligent man.
Shh! Why would you do that? Don't say that word.
Sorry.
I love days like today. But do you want gin?
I suppose so.
I'll keep my place in the queue, will you? I'll fetch it. Save some time.
But what was it you wanted?
Oh, yes. Razor blades, old fellow. Have you got any going spare?
No, none. I've tried everywhere. They don't seem to exist anymore. I've been using the same blade for 6 weeks.
Look at this old fellow laugh. That's the spirit. Look at him hold up his hand. Only one finger left. Frostbite got the rest, but he's not complaining. Working in those roofless sheds in the north, casting the iron bombs that will destroy our enemies. Look at his big smile. We can all take heart from this jolly fellow. All follow his example. No complaining. Complaint is thought crime.
Did you go to the hangings last night?
I was working. I'll watch them on the telescreen tonight.
Well, it was a nice evening. Perhaps room for a good summer. I know you. I see through you. I know perfectly well why you don't go to the hangings.
What?
Your thought crimes are all over your face. They'll hang you too. What was that, Smith?
I missed what you said.
I said, I think we're in for a good summer.
I hope so.
It spoils things when they tie their feet together. I like watching them kick. And no sacks, so you can see their blue tongues. What about you?
Oh, you know.
Are you going to use your saccharin tablet?
Probably not.
Mind if I...
Go ahead.
I like your articles. But, you know, I don't think you really appreciate Newspeak, Smith. When you write it, you're still thinking in old speak. I've read some of the pieces you write for the Times occasionally. They're good enough. But they're translations. In your head, you compose in old speak, then convert it on the page. In your heart, you'd prefer to stick to old speak with all its useless shades.
I do try, you know.
No, certainly. As I say, they're good, but they could be better. I read your piece about the athletics champion, Ogilvy. How he died on a floating fortress. Very moving. But too flowery. People don't want to hold thoughts like that in their heads anymore.
I made him up, completely. The on person I was erasing from the newspaper.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.